is an art, the building up of suspense.
Heads.
Though it can be done by luck alone.
Heads.
If one could call it that.
That's 76 love. Heads. 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 That's 85 in a row! That's a new record!
I'm afraid.
Me too.
I'm afraid today's not your day.
I'm afraid that it is. Are you happy?
What?
Content. At ease.
I suppose so.
What are you going to do now?
I don't know. What do you want to do?
I have no desires.
None.
There was a messenger. That's right. We have been sent for. Syllogism. One. Probability is a factor that operates within natural forces. Two. Probability is not operating as a factor. Three. We are now within sub or supernatural forces.
I'm sorry, what? What's the matter with you today?
A scientific approach to the examination of phenomena is a defense against the pure emotion of fear. Now, following me carefully. Now, if we postulate, and we just have, that within sub or supernatural forces, the probability is that the law of probability will not operate as a factor, then we must accept that the probability of the first part will not operate as a factor, in which case the law of probability will operate as a factor within unsub or supernatural forces. But since it obviously has not been doing so, we can take it that we are not held within unsub or supernatural forces after all. In all probability, that is. Which is a great relief to me personally. Thought very well. It's like we've been spinning coins together since I don't know when. And well, the equanimity of your average tosser of coins depends upon the law, or rather a tendency, or let us say the probability, or at any rate, a mathematically calculable chance which ensures that he will not upset himself by losing too much, nor his opponent by winning too often. This made for a kind of harmony and a kind of confidence that united the fortuitous and the ordained into a reassuring union, which we recognize as nature. The sun comes up as often as it goes down, and in the long run, a coin showed heads as often as it showed tails. Then the messenger arrived. We had been sent for, and now 85 coins spun consecutively have come down heads 85 consecutive times!
And another curious scientific phenomenon is the fact that the fingernails continue to grow after death, as does the beard.
What?
Beard.
But you're not dead.
I didn't say they started to grow after death. The fingernails also grow before birth, though not the beard.
What?
Beard! What's the matter with you today? The toenails, on the other hand, never grow at all.
The toenails, on the other hand, never grow at all.
Well, maybe they do. I don't know. I cut my fingernails all the time, but to the best of my knowledge, I've never cut my toenails. They'll be curled up under my feet by now. But they're not. Maybe I do it absentmindedly while thinking of something else.
Do you remember the first thing that happened this morning?
Oh, I woke up!
I suppose.
Oh, wait! That man! Far enough!
A messenger!
He was sent for!
Yes!
It was an urgent, a matter of extreme urgency. A royal summons! His very words. Official business. No questions asked.
Well, we'd better get on then.
Right! Onward!
Forward!
Right! Wait! Which way did we... Which way did we...
Hamlet's transformation, so call it. Sith nor the exterior, nor the inward man resembles that it was. What it should be, more than his father's death, that thus had put him so much from the understanding of himself, I cannot dream of. I entreat you both that, being of so young days brought up with him, and since so neighbored to his youth and behavior, that you vouchsafe your rest here in our court some little time, so by your companies to draw him on to pleasures.
We both obey, And here, give up ourselves in the full bent to lay our service freely at your feet, to be commanded.
Thanks, Rosencrantz. And, gentle Guildenstern.
I want to go home!
We'll soon be home and high. I mean, dry and home.
Which way do we come in? My sense of direction!
I'll hie you home, and...
Oh, it's all over my head!
Dry you high... Ah, there! Shh! We'll soon be home and dry. And high and dry. Has it ever happened to you that all of a sudden, and for no particular reason, you haven't the faintest idea how to spell the word wife or house? Because when you write it down, you just can't recall ever having seen the letters in that order before.
I remember.
Yes?
I remember when there were no questions.
Well, there were always questions.
There were always answers.
There's a logic at work here. Tread warily. Relax. Just until events have played themselves out.
And what have we got to go on?
Well, Hamlet's transformation. What do we recollect?
Well, he's changed.
The exterior and interior land fail to resemble. Draw him on to pleasures. Leave what afflicts him. Something more than his father's death.
He's always talking about us. There are no people on earth on whom he dotes on more than us.
We can cheer him up, find out what's the matter.
Exactly. It's a matter of asking the right questions, but giving away as little as we can. It's a game.
We could play questions.
What good would that achieve?
Practice.
Statement! One love.
That's cheating.
How?
Haven't started yet.
Statement! Two love.
Are you counting that?
What?
Are you counting that?
Foul! No repetitions. 3-0. One
game. If you're going to play like that, I don't want to play!
Whose serve is it?
Huh?
Foul! No grunts! Love one.
Why not?
What for?
Foul! No synonyms. One all.
What in God's name is going on here?
Foul! No rhetoric. 2-1.
Were you addressing me?
Are you serious?
Was that rhetoric?
No!
Statement! 2-2. Game point.
What's the matter with you today?
When?
What?
Are you deaf?
Am I dead?
Yes or no?
Is there a choice?
Is there a God?
Foul! No non-circulars! 3-2-1 game all! What? Who was that?
Don't you know him?
He didn't know me.
He didn't see you.
I didn't see him.
I hardly recognized him. He's changed!
You can see that?
Transformed.
How exactly?
Both inside and out.
I see. He's changed.
Lean what afflicts him.
How?
Question and answer. You question, I'll answer.
He's not himself, you know.
I'm him, you see.
Well, who am I then?
You or yourself. Address me.
My dear Guildenstern.
You've forgotten, haven't you?
My dear Rosencrantz.
I don't think you quite understand. What we are attempting here is a hypothesis in which I answer for him, while you ask me questions.
Oh, you have me confused.
My honored lord.
My dear fellow.
How are you?
Afflicted.
Really? In what way?
Transformed.
Inside or out?
Both.
I see. Not much new there.
Go into details. Delve. Probe the background. Establish a situation.
So your uncle is the king of Denmark.
And my father before him.
His father before him?
No, my father before him.
I see. So your father was king. You were his only son. Your father dies. You are his only heir. Your uncle becomes king.
Yes.
Unorthodox.
Undid me.
And your mother's marriage?
Indecent.
Hasty.
Suspicious.
And to sum up, your father, whom you love, dies. You are his only son. You come back to find that hardly was the corpse cold before his younger brother popped onto the throne and into the sheets, thereby offending both legal and natural practices. Now, why exactly are you behaving in this extraordinary manner?
I can't possibly imagine.
Yet he did send for us. And we did come.
My most dear lord!
My excellent good friends! How dost thou, Guildenstern? Or is it Rosencrantz? Ah, Rosencrantz. My good lads, how do you both?
I think we can say that we made some headway.
You think so?
I think we can say that.
I think we can say he made us look ridiculous.
He caught us on the wrong foot once or twice, but I think we gained some ground.
He murdered us!
He had 6 rhetoricals and 2 repetitions.
I was waiting for you to delve! When is he going to start delving, I asked myself.
We got his symptoms, didn't we?
I thought he said about something else, and the other didn't even mean anything at all.
Thwarted ambition. A sense of grievance. That's my diagnosis.
6 rhetoricals and 2 repetitions. Leaving 19, of which we entered 50. And what do we get in return? He's depressed. Denmark's a prison in his rather little nutshell. Some shadow play about the nature of ambition. And finally, one direct question which might have led somewhere.
Ah! I think we did well.
Friends, move! Go join in you with some further aid! Hamlet, in madness, hath Polonius slain. Go seek him out. Speak fair, and bring the body into the chapel. I pray you hasten this.
Well,
quite.
Well, well.
Quite.
Seek him out, etc.
He could be anywhere.
Okay. You look that way, I'll go this way.
All right. Oh, wait. I'll go that way, you go this way.
Okay.
Wait. We ought to stick together. He might be violent.
Good point. I'll come with you.
No. I'll come with you.
Okay.
Oh, hold on. I'll go with you my way. If he comes here, that'd be stupid, wouldn't it?
Good point. I'll stay, you go.
Right. Oh, wait. We ought to stick together. He might be violent.
Good point. Well, at least we're getting somewhere. Have we anything else to go on?
Ooh, you can give him a shout.
We've already been through all that.
Hamlet!
Take it, sir!
Oh. Lord Hamlet! What hast thou done with the body, my lord?
The body? The body is with the king, but the king is not with the body. The king is a thing.
A thing, my lord?
Of nothing. Bring me to him.
How now? What hath befallen?
Where the body is bestowed, my lord, we cannot get from him.
Bring him before me.
What are you waiting for? Bring in the lord.
We were breakfast with omelet.
Aside from in a box. That's the part. I don't think of that, frankly.
That's why I come to think about it.
Because you know you'd be helpless, wouldn't you? Stuffed into a box like that. Even in taking account the fact that you're dead, really. Ask yourself. I'm going to ask you straight up. I'm going to stuff you in this box. Would you rather be alive or dead? Naturally, you prefer to be alive. Life in a box is better than no life at all. You can lie there if... Well, at least I'm not dead. In a minute, someone's going to come along, knock on the door and go, "What's your name? What's your name? Come out of there!"
Try not to think about it if I were you. I would get depressed. Eternity is a terrible thought.